Either way, you are selling, but you need to predict what happens with what you sell over time. This is what we mean by quantitative sales forecasting. Quantitative are numbers, numerical figures, in terms of what we are going to sell, what we are about to sell.
Thanks, good.
It's about, so when we talk about quantitative sales forecasting, businesses want to sell in terms of tangible, in terms of services like insurance, like banking, like tourism, whatever it is, we are selling and consumers will have to buy. So what do we do as sales person? How do we become a sales person? We become a sales person because we are trying to convince customers to buy. That's why we are a sales person. Do you get the point here? We are trying to convince customers to buy what we are selling. That makes us a sales person. So, what do you have to do? You can compare what happens in the past with what is going to happen, what is happening presently, and what you think will happen in the future. That's not what quantitative sales forecasting is. So we have different methods in which we can use to calculate sales forecasting. One of the methods is time series analysis. When we talk about time series analysis, applies to using arithmetical method based on figures of the past, historical figures of the past, comparing it with now and predicting what could happen over time. That is what time series analysis is. So for us to calculate time series analysis, we can use the moving average method to calculate time series analysis. So how do we use the moving average method to calculate time series analysis? You watch it in the first video. So here today, we have 3 period moving averages, and we have 4 period moving averages. These are ways in which we can calculate our quantitative sales forecasting using time series analysis. So we can use the moving average. So the moving average will be for the next 3 years or for the next 4 years. That's all about this. So let's see what happens here. This is a company that has worked for like 10 years in a row. So the company wants to use its time series analysis to get the forecast for all this. But we have some information for the sales revenue. So we have 100 for the revenue here, 130, 160, 175, 180, 190, 190, 180, 220. And 250. What do we want to get from this? We want to be sure if the revenue is going up or it's going down or it remains constant. The other side here, we're using time series analysis. We're using the moving average to confirm if our revenue is going up, down, or it's constant. So we get to know. We can make sure with the graph, that is line of basis, that is not now. For now, we are using time series analysis. And for time series analysis, we can use this average or this average. So we start. So this is the revenue of a company. So we want to check what happens with the revenue over time using 3 period moving average. We have the calculator here. So to calculate, For the third period moving average, you calculate the first, the second, and the third year. You divide it by 3. Then the next one, or the subsequent one, you take away the first year. You continue with the second year. You get to know it now. So you need to calculate for the first 3 periods. So this plus this plus this. So we have 100 plus 130 plus 160. 390, so we have 390 divided by 3. So we have 130. So for the first 3 years, it's going to be writing on the second year as what? 130.
Why are you doing it on the second year?
Because we're calculating for the first third year. So the third year starts from the second year. We calculate for the third year. And the third year starts from the calculation of the second year.
What about the first year?
The The first year is the year at which our revenue just started. So calculating the first year, only calculating is getting the average. So if you are calculating for year three, year two will decide year three. What happens with year two determines what happens with year three. So what happens with year four decide is determined by what happens in year three.
So year one, like,
yeah, it's zero for year one. So you divide it with the number, but when you start calculating, you start with the second year. So we have, this is done. So the first year is done. For the third year, for the fourth year, we have to calculate this plus this divided by three. So we have 130 plus 160 plus 175.
165.
465. Then we have 465 divided by three. So we have 155. Is it clear? So this is the moving average for year four. The moving average for year three is in year two. The moving average for year four is in year three. So now we're looking for the moving average for year five, which we recorded in year four. So this is gone. This plus this plus this divided by three. So we have 160 plus 175 plus 180. 515. So we have 515 divided by 2. So we have 171.6. Is it clear? So we move on. Is it clear, please?
Yes.
Moving average. Year one. Year two. This is year three, right? 155, right?
Yes.
Year three.
155.
This is year four, right?
Year four.
Year four is 171.6. Now go to year five. For year five, this is done. 175 plus 180 plus 190 divided by 3. We have 545 for year 5. 181.6. Is it clear? Now go to year 5, year 6, right?
Yes.
This plus this. So we have 180 plus 190 plus 190, 560 divided by 560. So we have for year 6, 560 divided by 186.6. For year 7, this is done. So we have 190 plus 560 divided by 3. Thank you.